The last 15 years we're after seeing a property boom, property wealth in Dublin, new cars, new apartments and this. But 70 years ago, it was the horse that done all the hard work, all the deliveries around the city, pulled the barges up along the canal, and people seem to forget all this. But if we see old footage of Dublin, this is all you see, horse and traps and carts around the city of Dublin. And we should never, ever, ever forget what the horse has done for the city, and not just like leave him on a postcard on the mantelpiece. He was part of the building of all the city of Dublin. I'm up at 7 o'clock in the morning, quick wash, go down, have breakfast. I'm down in the field checking on the horses for 7:30. Make sure they're all right and they're in good condition. People don't appreciate the owner of a horse, the time he has given, the vital things. You have to like clean them out and make sure he's in good, healthy order. There's a lot more to it than just opening up a gate in the field and letting the horse in and eat grass.
I've been doing this for the last 20 years, like keeping the land, making sure everything is in order and that.
Ah, well, it's great to get out of the hustle and bustle, like out of that traffic and down to this area. Like, it's fabulous to listen to the birds, like, and the horses and the wildlife that's down here. It's really soothing, like, it is a beautiful place, I must say. A lot of people, like, also use, like, the cut through here, use this place for walks, like, and that. So it's a fabulous place, like, to get out, like, and just, like, chill out.
And, like, it's still not too far from the city centre either. It's a beautiful area. And there's not very many places left, like, land around us, near the city, because it's all after being built up.
This is what it's about also, like giving the horse a break out of the city and letting him come out here, like giving him like a couple of months off. It's a great break for them.
Well, it's a great thing, I think, for people like to take them around horses, like, you know, like they can get like so close to them, and like they're such a beautiful animal, like, and I think it's great relaxing,
and for the people in general that pass through here, I think it's a beautiful thing to see the horse on the land. It'd be great for the kids' future, yeah, if they could set up some types of place like this, be it like for the inner city kids and that. Like, I think it'd be really a great help. love of horses would have developed through my father. I worked with my father delivering horses around different parts of Ireland and Dublin and that. He worked for an uncle of mine, Coopers were their name, and they were the big horse dealers. And they supplied the dairies, Dublin dairies, and Guinnesses. And my father also kept like greyhounds. As I says, he was a bookie one time, my father was. Himself and his father, they had a betting shop. My grandfather, he was a cattle dealer, and he also bought ponies and that sometimes. And he would, they came from Prussia Street beside the cattle market there. So I was always around like animals and seeing them in the different yards growing up. This is Frankie, this is what we call him. Aren't you, boy? And he's an honest horse. And he's so quiet, actually. A child, you could sleep underneath him, between his legs. I have Frankie the last 5 years, and he's really a fabulous horse, he is. And he's a great horse. He's a joy, actually, to work with Frankie, is. And he's what you call, he's a one-off, Frankie is. Because the bond I have with him is, it's really fabulous. And as I says, I'd have no problem there sitting down, having a sandwich, or having a cup of tea. And as I says, there's not a kick in his body. My uncle, Joe Cooper, he had a trap in the Phoenix Park, and he had a Jervy walking up at the Dublin Zoo, driving his trap around. So I always like fancied. Thought someday I'd yoke up a horse myself and take people around the city of Dublin and that. Well, we take people around the city of Dublin, take them on the tours. It's called the Georgian Tour. Take them all around the government buildings and all the old Georgian houses, Grand Canal, Guinness's, Dublin Castle. So you get great enjoyment, and it's a great kickback you get from the people when you show them all these places and that. And Dublin people as well, they don't realise the history about all these Georgian houses and the different galleries and libraries we have in the city. It's more private when you go on the horse and carriage. Like if you're on a tour bus, like a tour bus that only comes off an assembly line. Like the horse, it's a living thing. And where we go, the tour buses don't go the same places. I think a horse is like actually splendid, and a horse, he understands you, like, and like the power and the strength and what a horse can do and what they have done like for the country, like in the racing industry. People have different opinions on the horse, but I honestly think that there's something unique about a horse.
It's very unusual to see the horses in the city, like, you know, like, I think it's the only way to see the city, it's the proper way to see the city, like by the horse and carriage, like, to be quite honest. Need a carriage, folks.